Well, live shows are starting to make their return, and our very funny friend Rove McManus has his sticky fingers all over the latest comedy event, and Rove joins us now. Rove, live comedy is back, and I've heard a lot of comics that I might know have been quite nervous about getting back on stage. How are you feeling?
I've been warming up to this. I did some shows in Newcastle over the weekend, and the scene in Sydney has been pretty good to get our toes back out there. But this is going to be at the Opera House, Wilco. So I'm nervous about it. This is a big deal.
Good way to eat
classy.
I reckon. Yeah, the Opera House. It's great. That first day though that you stepped out on any stage after lockdown, it would have been months since you'd done anything. Is it different?
Well, it's different in that. Well, what it's the normal part of it is, you're only playing to a room that's half full. What's different is that it's because of COVID. At least that's what you tell yourself now. And what I will tell myself until like the year 2025.
Yeah. Right, a lot of comics were doing Zoom gigs. I know I've done a few this year. I know you've done some. I imagine the atmosphere. You're hoping for a different atmosphere at the Opera House with the people in the room than the Zoom gigs.
I'm sure it'll be molto bene, grazie. sorry, Pete, just for a sec. Could you apri la finestra? It's very stuffy in here. I'm looking forward to it. It's gonna be great. There's a lot of comics have been dying to get back up on stage. And what I've also found too is a lot of audience members, people who have otherwise been trapped at home and maybe doing Zoom meetings. I mean, any Zoom conversation, whether it's a meeting or a stand-up show or anything else, isn't quite the same as being in the room. And I found that people on stage and in the audience are so excited. It makes for a wonderful atmosphere when you get to get back together.
I'm so jealous. I wish I was either performing or in the audience tomorrow night. It's going to be fantastic. And the lineup is fantastic. You've got Edo and Edmonds, Becky Lucas, Tom Walker, Merrick Watts. What's going to be harder, keeping everybody sober backstage or stopping Merrick Watts from banging on about SAS Australia?
Well, I'm worried that he'll sit and interrogate us or something. Put a hood over our heads and drag us out of the venue in the middle of the night. The other thing about Merrick, I think, is exactly what you hit the nail on the head, Pete. Merrick loves his wine. You would know. You've done winery tours with him. So that's probably going to be the biggest fear, not only that Merrick is there, but he's bringing good wine from what I hear. So hopefully we can keep ourselves together until the end of the show.
Very quickly, Rove, we do know that your favourite show is, of course, Doctor Who, which turned, I think, 57 the other day.
57, yes.
Did you do something special to celebrate?
I did. Shut up, Mark. I did. And I don't care who knows it. I watched the original episode, An Unearthly Child, that went to air 57 years ago. And then I went and re-watched that same episode but found the original dodgy pilot that never went to air, that was really, really bad to the point where the show never almost happened. So it was quite thrilling to watch that. I can see why it didn't air. It was terrible.
And, that is commitment.
But it was the difference between the show being here 57 years later or almost not happening.
Hey, did they...
Well, we're pleased for you.
Have they opened the window for you yet, Rove? Is it right? Comfortable? Did they open the window for you there?
They did. The finestra is absolutely up.
Well, for all the info on where you can get tickets to the Let's Laugh live comedy show, shut up, Rove, head to our website. Thanks for joining us.
Oofa.